Hey everyone, this is Dom from Tech Advisor, and I'm here to round up the best budget or cheap phones that are in the market right now. I'm recording this in June 2022, so this is a kind of state of the market as it stands. Obviously, this will change a bit. We try and do these videos every 6 months or so. So this is gonna be up to date for a while. But if you're watching this way, way, way in the future, then look for a more recent version of the video. Okay, so I'm gonna be picking out my five favorite budget phones right now. There's a few things I wanna get out of the way before we get into them though. First things first, three of these phones are made by Xiaomi. I'm sorry, I can't help it. I tried to put in a bit more variety, but they are just the best in this space right now, and that's partly a numbers game. Between their Redmi and Poco brands, they managed to hurl out a lot of budget phones, and a lot of them offer a lot of value for money. That has a knock-on effect. It means if you're in the US, this may not be super useful to you, because I'm afraid only one of the phones I'm gonna talk about today is actually on sale in the US, and it's a Motorola. If you're in Europe or Asia, you're gonna be able to access all of the phones I'm talking about, but it is just one of the quirks of the US budget market, I'm afraid. It's very different handsets, and I haven't had the chance to try very many of them out. Then there's just the question of what these phones have in common. So, few things to know. One, the budget space still has a lot of 4G phones. And what you're generally gonna find is that between the 4G and 5G phones, A, 5G phones will be a little bit more expensive. B, they're genuinely gonna have cut corners elsewhere to make the 5G connectivity fit in. So bear that in mind, if you want those latest connection speeds, you're probably gonna sacrifice something somewhere else, or you're gonna pay a chunk more. For a lot of people, 4G is really still gonna make sense at this end of the market, but I have got some 5G options in here as well. The other thing is the things I'm not gonna talk about in every phone because they're just so similar. So one is battery. Every single one of the five phones I'm talking about today has a 5,000 mAh battery. Literally everyone, they all have the exact same battery capacity. They're all gonna give you a day or two of battery life. This is gonna be similar across almost all budget phones. You're gonna struggle to find one with a smaller battery or a bigger battery than that. It's just the way it is at this end of the market. The other thing is camera performance. I'll talk a little bit about main cameras because they do vary slightly. But generally, all of these phones will take decent photos in daylight, rubbish photos at night, and they're all gonna have an 8-megapixel ultrawide you won't wanna use very often, and probably a 2-megapixel macro or depth sensor, sometimes both, and again, you won't wanna use them very often. So, camera performance, there'll be one lens that matters, it'll vary a little, the others are rubbish, so pretend they're not there. Okay, that was a way longer intro than I planned to record, so without further ado, let's get into the actual phones I wanna talk about. First up, I'm gonna start with those three Xiaomi models I talked about, because let's just get them out of the way. I'm gonna begin with the most expensive of the lot, the Poco X4 Pro 5G. Now, at £259 and €299, this is actually technically slightly more expensive than what we consider budget, but only by £10, and it's on sale so often that most of the time you're gonna find it in what we think of as that budget range below 250 quid here in the UK. So, this is still definitely worth looking at. There are perks that come with the fact that it's just that little bit more expensive. For one, as I mentioned, it's got 5G. Two, it's got an IP53 rating, which actually all the Xiaomi phones have, but it also uses Gorilla Glass 5 to protect the display, whereas 3 is more common in the other phones. So that means it's a little bit more resistant to drops and scratches and breaking and that kind of thing. It's also got the fastest charging of any of the phones I'm gonna talk about today at 67 watts. That basically means you'll be able to charge this, get most of a full charge in the time you're getting ready in the morning or something like that. So you don't need to leave it plugged in overnight. The Poco X4 Pro 5G also has the highest resolution camera in the budget phones I'm talking about today at 108 megapixels. Now, resolution isn't everything, and honestly, this camera isn't a lot better than the others we're talking about, but it does mean if you really care about it, you'll be able to get a little bit more detail out of your shots. But still, as I said at the beginning, this would be capable of good shots in good light and bad shots in bad light. And that's just gonna be the case no matter how many extra megapixels they cram into the sensor. Last thing is, this is quite a big phone. It's got a 6.7 inch display and it's a nice one. It's 120 hertz AMOLED, which is I think the best of all the phones I'm talking about today, but it does mean it's a fairly big phone. So if your budget will stretch that little bit further, this is probably the budget phone to buy. Now I'm gonna stick with Poco, and I'm gonna kinda cheat a little bit here and actually include two models together, the Poco M4 Pro and the M4 Pro 5G. And it's really common in this space that when two phones come out and there's one 4G version and one 5G version, they're actually radically different devices. But that's not the case here. The M4 Pro and the M4 Pro 5G are broadly similar. And that's why I've lumped them in together. Still, there are some key differences you want to be aware of. The obvious one is price. The 4G model starts at £189, €219. The 5G jumps up to £239, €229. There are differences elsewhere though. The 5G model is a little bit bigger. It also has an LCD display, whereas you're getting an AMOLED display in the 4G model. So there is a genuine trade-off there. They both have the same battery size, they both have 33-watt charging, and they both have an IP53 waterproof rating. Cameras are slightly different in specs, chipsets are slightly different, but actual performance at the end of the day is really similar between the two phones. There's really not a lot to pick from there. The one thing to look out for is the 5G model starts with less RAM and storage than the 4G model does, which makes that price gap actually seem a little different when you really think about it. For my money, I'd go for the 4G one because it's one of the cheapest budget phones around that we'd still recommend. Once you get below that £200 line, performance really starts to drop, and the Poco M4 Pro is a really, really solid 4G device. But if you're looking for a 5G model and you can't quite reach the price of the X4 Pro, the M4 Pro 5G is definitely, definitely worth considering. Okay, now it is time for the final Xiaomi phone. I promise I'm not doing any more Xiaomi once we've got past this one. So now it's the Xiaomi Redmi Note 11. Be careful, there are a lot of Redmi phones or even a lot of Redmi Note 11 phones, but the regular Redmi Note 11 is the one that we think is the pick of the bunch. It's the best balance of features. Now, Redmi and Poco are both part of Xiaomi, as I've mentioned. And the funny thing about the Redmi Note 11 is it's kind of like a remix of those two M4 Pro phones. So you're getting the design and build and size of the 4G M4 Pro, and this is a 4G phone as well, to be clear, but you're getting the camera setup from the Poco M4 Pro 5G and a couple other specs that pull from that. It's a 6.43-inch display like the M4 Pro 4G, so it's that bit smaller. That means it's compact, that means it's light. You still get the IP53 rating, you still got the same battery, the same 33-watt charging. You're still gonna get decent performance. So this is a really nicely balanced budget handset. And you only have to pay a little bit more than the Poco for it. It's £199 and it's actually €199 as well. So I think in Europe, the Redmi works out slightly cheaper than the Poco does. Let's move away from Xiaomi and now we're onto Realme, which is the sort of budget-focused offshoot of Oppo, if you know them. My pick this year is the Realme 9, which is, as you might expect, at the core of their Realme 9 series, which is their latest set of kind of budget to cheap mid-range stuff. Now note, this is the Realme 9, not the Realme 9 5G, because the 5G is actually a very different phone. In fact, to complicate things, there are two Realme 9 5Gs, depending on whether you're in India or Europe, and they're both different, but they're both a bit worse than the 4G one. So this is one case where I would definitely stick with 4G, and if you want 5G, look elsewhere. So, the strengths of the Realme 9. It's got the best design of any of these phones, at least from my perspective. I think it looks really stunning. It looks like a much more expensive phone than it really is. It doesn't scream budget or cheap at all, even though it's still made out of plastic and stuff like that. I think it carries itself like a more expensive device. It's also got Gorilla Glass 5, which I mentioned was on the Poco X4 Pro, but it's not on any others. So this is the most secure, along with that, from drops and scratches and stuff like that. The downside is there's no IP rating at all, so there's no promise of water resistance. It's a smaller phone, it's a 6.4-inch display, it's a 90Hz AMOLED. You're getting similar camera specs and performance to what we've seen elsewhere, and again, that same 5,000 mAh battery. This time with 33-watt charging like we saw on the M4 and Redmi Note 11 phones. Two final things to note if you're thinking about the Realme 9. One, a bad thing. It doesn't come with NFC. Not all budget phones do, but most of the ones I've been talking about today do have NFC. Not including it means you cannot use this phone for contactless payments and things like that. The good news is, this is, I think, the only phone in this set that launches with Android 12, the latest version of the software. It's really common for budget phones to still be sort of one generation behind, but Realme has made a point of shipping this with Android 12 and committing to two Android version updates. So you know this will give you that longevity and you'll still be getting software patches for a couple of years to come. That does come at a slight price though. This is a £249, €279 phone. So it's a little more expensive than some of the others I've been talking about today. Still, I think for a lot of people that will be worth it because of that nice design and the improved software experience. Last but not least, we have the Motorola Moto G60S. As I hinted at the beginning, this is the only one of these five phones that is officially available in the US, though if you're really committed, you could probably import one of the other four. At £219 or €250 or dollars, this is again slightly at the pricier end of the budget space, but it's not too bad. It's also one of the biggest phones around. It's only the biggest I'm talking about today, with a 6.8-inch display. This is a very large phone, so bear that in mind. That could be a good thing or a bad thing, depending on your perspective. It doesn't have an IP rating, and it also doesn't use Gorilla Glass. So in a sense, this is one of the least durable ones, but it's worth saying Motorola does say it has a, and I quote, water-repellent design. I don't know how that compares to an official IP rating for water resistance, but it is at least something. Other than the sheer size, specs and features here are broadly in line with the other phones I've been talking about. You've got 120 Hz LCD display, you've got 4G rather than 5G connectivity, 64 megapixel main camera, and that same old 5000 milliamp-hour battery, though it is here paired with 50 watt wired charging, which is pretty fast for a phone at this price. The other thing I want to note is the software. Basically, Motorola ships software that is very, very close to stock Android, and I think that is going to be a big appeal to quite a lot of people, particularly compared to the Xiaomi phones I was speaking about, where MIUI, I certainly don't love MIUI, and I know a lot of other people feel the same way. I think the Realme software is a step above that, but this very close to stock experience on the Motorola will definitely have a lot of appeal for people who can put up with the size and heft of the G60S. As I said at the beginning, I think for most people you should look at 4G handsets here, but 5G ones are an option if you don't mind the downgrade elsewhere. I also wouldn't go a lot cheaper than the phones I've spoken about here. There are cheaper phones, some go as low as £100 or dollars, but the performance gap between a 200 phone and a 100 phone is enormous. There is a gulf there. And if you can stretch your budget up, I would really implore that you do. And if you can't quite meet the full price of these phones, just wait around till sales events like Prime Day or Black Friday, because they will often slash anywhere from 20 up to 50 or £60 or dollars off the prices, which really changes how affordable they are. So that's it from me. Jump in the comments and let me know if you think I'm wrong, or, you know, maybe even right. That would be nice. Remember to like and subscribe to the channel if you're a fan, and keep an eye out because we also put out videos around our best mid-range phone choices and our best flagship phone choices for summer 2020. So take a look at them too. Thanks.